Hi everyone, welcome to the another video. Today I'm gonna talk about the Booker Prize and Nobel Prize winning South African writer Nadine Gordimer. I'm gonna talk about her biography and about her major literary works. Nadine Gordimer was born in South Africa in the year 1923 and died in the year 2014. She was awarded the Booker Prize for Fiction for her novel The Conservationist in the year 1974, and she was also awarded Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 1991. Except this, Nadine Gordimer was also an activist in the anti-apartheid movement. Now, what was apartheid? Apartheid was a system or structure, or we can say a government policy, where there was a racial segregation or racial discrimination against the non-white people of Africa. So there was a division between the white and the non-white people of Africa that was existed in South Africa from 1948 and until the 1990s. And that is why most of her works are based on the theme of love, politics, and particularly on moral and racial issues. So, in brief, we can say that Nadine Gordimer was so much concerned about the racial discrimination in South Africa, and therefore she took the theme of racial issues for most of her works. Next, we have her important works. First, we have The Lying Days, published in the year 1953. It is a semi-autobiographical novel. It comes under the genre of Bildungsroman or coming of age novel. Now, what is Bildungsroman? It is a literary genre that focuses on the psychological and moral growth of the protagonist from youth to adulthood, in which character change is important. The literary meaning of Bildungsroman in education novel. The story of this novel is set in Johannesburg, South Africa. Here we have the protagonist, Helen Shaw, who is a white girl belonging to a middle class family. The story deals with her awareness about African life and her concern about the racial division. Next, we have Occasion for Loving, published in the year 1963. The theme of this novel is based on love and politics. The story talks about the forbidden romantic relationship between a wealthy white woman and an African artist during apartheid. Next, we have A Guest of Honor, published in the year 1970. It is a political novel that explores the role of revolutionary ideas in new African states. Next, we have the Booker Prize winning novel, The Conservationist, published in the year 1974. This novel is a character study of the anti-hero Mahering. Next, we have The Burgher's Daughter, published in the year 1979. It is a political and historical novel that is based on the anti-apartheid struggle. Here we find the reference of the activist Nelson Mandela and Soweto Uprising of 1976. This novel was banned. Next, we have July's People, published in the year 1981. This novel was also banned. The story deals with the fictional civil war, where the writer imagines the future version of South Africa where the apartheid system is ended. Next, we have The House Gun, published in the year 1998. The story talks about the two major characters, Claudia and Harold Lingard, who are dealing with their son's murder of one of his housemates. Next, we have The Pickup, published in the year 2001. Here we have the story of Julie Summers, the couple Julie Summers and Abdu. The theme is based on alienation, immigration, class, and economic power. Next, we have Get a Life, published in the year 2005. The story talks about the protagonist, Paul Bannerman, who is suffering from thyroid cancer. Now, this novel is different from his previous novels, as this novel talks about a struggle of a single individual. Next we have her collection of short stories, A Soldier's Embrace, Crimes of Conscience, Loot and Other Stories. Next we have the collection of essays, Notes from Our Century. And last we have the remarks. The writer Per Wasberg appreciated the novel Conservationist through the words densest and most poetical novel. So that was all about Nadine Gordimer. If you have any query, then post your comments in the comment section below. Thank you.